Now to some startling numbers. Over 700,000 Canadian children live in parts of the country that don't have available daycare spaces. That is according to a new study. CTV's Molly Thomas is following the story for us this morning. Molly, what have you got for us?
Well, Marcia, experts are calling these child care deserts. So these are specifically areas where three or more children have access to just one licensed spot. And that's happening in 44% of our country, 44%. Let me show you exactly where this is the worst. So in Saskatoon, every child lives in a child care desert. Ontario has eight cities where 40% or more are living in these so-called deserts. Compare this to Charlottetown or Quebec, where fewer than 5% of children are underserved in those areas. Now, these cities take a more active role in regulating child care and are more likely to have broader coverage in their areas. Now, this makes sense, of course, for Quebec. That province is actively planning for where those centres should go actually right now and also has the highest subsidized daycare rates in the country. The study also notes that daycare deserts, they exist in both rich areas and poor areas, so no one's discriminated against there. So the report is really asking for affordable options for all the parents out there, those struggling to make ends meet, or even those just trying to balance a career and kids. So you have to keep in mind this study, Marcia, it only considers licensed daycares. It's not thinking of unlicensed spots because there's no comprehensive list to assess that data. But of course, the licensed ones are the ones that the federal government is usually, you know, giving money towards.
Okay. And in terms of the federal government, what's the reaction to this shortage?
So there is a plan. Ottawa has committed $1.7 billion over 10 years. Provinces like BC have committed to funding a system where affordable and quality licensed care is available for every family that wants it. The good news is 9,700 spaces are expected to be created over the next 3 years through this federal funding. Now, the new spaces will target underserved communities and marginalized populations. There's also some news for parents who work shift work out there and have irregular hours. Daycare spaces are set to be created specifically for you. And researchers really hope this report will put some public pressure on policymakers to show them the immensity of the problem, because they know that childcare is healthy for Canada. It helps close the gender gap, spurs economic growth, Marcia, and eases, you know, the stress on parents trying to do really the best for their kids.
Okay, of course. Thanks for that, Molly. Appreciate it.